Hey guys, what's up? This is Adrian Onigiri, and this is my Anime Expo and Any Song experience in Los Angeles. Check it out. So for Anime Expo, I only went one day this year. I only went on July 1st on a Saturday. I only went one day because it was kind of hard for me to find time off of work, and then it was pretty expensive too, so I only made a one-day trip, so yeah. So then on that day, I took Amtrak from where I live to Los Angeles, and then I took it back right after the concert. So when I first got to LA, guys, there I went straight to the line. Like, I was confused where the line was because it was pretty long, but like, turns out that what I thought was the back of the line was actually the beginning of the line, and I was just like walking to the back of the line forever. It took like 30 minutes to walk to the back of the line. It was pretty crazy and ridiculous. Like, we went through like 3 overpasses in LA. It was just like, it was insane, guys. Yeah, check out this video I got at the LineCon. My phone was like really bad, as you can see. Thankfully I saw my friend, and then I waited for her while I was in line. She was there for like 2 hours, and then I saw her, and then we waited for like 3 more hours. So she's been there for 5 hours and I've been there for 3 hours. But yeah guys, like LineCon was like no good this year. Yeah. 1 hour later and we're still here, right Trina? After I waited in LineCon, it was around like 5:30-ish. And then Any Song was gonna start around 6 o'clock, so I'm like, oh my god, I need to get there ASAP. So like, yeah, I got my badge, and then it turns out you had to wait in line just to go inside the convention. So yeah, Anime Expo was pretty crazy, there was like thousands of people, so yeah. So I met up with my friend, and then we went straight to Any Song. So yeah guys, I met up with friends, and then we were waiting for Any Song World Matsuri. I was really excited for Any Song World Matsuri because there's going to be a lot of Japanese guests there, so I was really happy to see them perform, yeah. So it was held at the Microsoft Theater, and the Microsoft Theater was such a cool venue. Like, it was so huge, it was in the middle of LA, it was like awesome. I'm so happy I was able to go to that. Like yeah, it was like insane guys, like check out this picture of it. So yeah guys, without further ado, they let us in for the Any Song World Matsuri. Yes. So like I was with my friends, and then like the tickets we got were like kind of like the like very like nosebleed seats, so we're like but it's alright because like I was so happy I was able to go. So then like we found our seats and stuff, and I was so happy that all the scenes were about to come out and stuff, yeah. But the only thing is, videos were really loud at the concert, so I couldn't take a lot of videos, but towards the very end of the concert I managed to get some pictures though. So one of the main reasons why I came to Any Song World Matsuri is because Garden Delia was performing. I saw Garden Delia last year back at the J-Pop Summit, and then they did really good, so I'm like, I definitely need to see them again. And which they did an amazing job, God bless to Garden Delia, yeah. So like, as soon as the concert opened, there was like a lot of Japanese guests. Like, I was so happy to see like Konomi and Suzuki, like Garden Delia, Ali Project was there, Angela, Minori Chihara, Mashiro Ayane. So like yeah, a lot of like good Japanese like Any Song singers were there, so I was really happy to see all of them perform. I also managed to get a little video of Konomi Suzuki performing. Check it out guys on the next slide.
This song is important song. TV anime, No Game No Life, opening moment. This game.
Concert, I was most excited to see Konomi Suzuki because she did the ReZero opening and I love that anime. And then I was really happy to see Garden Delia, of course, and then Angela did a really good job as well, and then like Minori Chihara, like they all did a really great job. It was just like, it was such a good night guys, like it was really awesome. But yeah, guys, like also at the concert, everybody had a little glide stick that light up, but then me and my friends forgot about it, so we didn't end up buying it. But I really wish you bought it though. It was like so cool. Everyone's all like, yeah, but it was a really great concert. Like all of them like rocked it, like they were really good. Like I was so happy I was able to go this year. And then at the very end of the concert, guys, all the Japanese guests joined hands and then they all bowed. And it was so amazing. I'm just like, yes, God bless you guys for coming. Like, it was so amazing. I'm really happy that Anime Expo hosted the Anisong this year. It was just like a great experience. Yeah. Yeah. And then I took a lot of pictures of them, like, all the guests at the very end. Yeah, it was a really memorable night. Like, all the guests were like so happy at the very end. It was just like, yes, yes, definitely. So, like, after Anisong was over, then I had like a few more hours left and I had to go back to take my Antrax back home. So yeah. So then I left LA around like 1 a.m. and then I got back home around like 7 a.m. the next day. So then as soon as I got back home, I just like fell asleep and then yeah, my Anime Expo journey was over that day. I'm like, no. Yeah, even though I won for only one day, it was still a memorable experience. I got to see some friends I knew, and then like I got to attend Anisong, so yeah. But definitely for next year for Anime Expo, I plan to go for the whole entire weekend, guys. Like, I will do this. Yeah, I love Anime Expo. Alright, thank you guys for watching so much. This is Adrian Onigiri, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.
We out, hey, yeah, Anisong is going down, yeah, Konomi Suzuki.